G'day guys, how you going? Hope you're all doing very well. Spanish Journal 669, Friday Review of the House of Horror. The film I've chosen to review for you this Friday is a film from Australia, English language, released in the year 2010, directed by Adam Blakelock, and this movie is called Caught Inside. And the story of Caught Inside is as follows. Ever been stuck with a friend who crosses the line? When a group of surfers venture to a secluded island paradise on the safari of their lives, one of them breaks the rule by bringing the one thing that can tear them apart, a beautiful single woman. Lured to these perfect waters by local surf legend Bull, civilization becomes a mere speck on the horizon. It's only a matter of time before tensions rise and friendships fracture. When Bull snaps, violently asserting himself once and for all, he single-handedly turns the dream vacation into a nightmare, fight for survival. On a boat in the middle of nowhere, you just can't walk away. So the movie centers around a group of friends that are going on a vacation to get away from the busy city lifestyle, and they decide to take up an offer by Bull, who is a local surfing legend. Now, Bull is a little bit of a lunatic. He's got a very harsh sort of temper. And the group of friends, they decide to accompany him on this ship, on this boat, and the boat sails to this very secluded island. So it seems like a perfect getaway, but pretty soon tensions start to mount, and the person in the mix of it is this single woman. Now, this single woman basically rejects Bull's advances, and she actually likes someone else. So that creates a bit of jealousy. And these jealousies spill over into something a hell of a lot more. So what happens at that point on, it's a terrifying event that occurs. And basically, they're trapped with Bull on this boat in the middle of nowhere, and they just can't walk away from it. So what happens at that point on, it's something you're going to have to find out for yourself. So hopefully, I've done a good enough job with the synopsis to make you want to go out there and have a look at it. Now, my thoughts on the film. This is one of the Australian films that really hasn't got talked about much at all. It didn't really get a lot of publicity in Australia. I didn't even know it existed until I came across this in the video store. So I reviewed this on my personal channel a very long time ago, but I thought I'd have another sort of talk about it since I just rewatched it not long ago. So basically what we have, it is a fairly solid Australian film, but ultimately it falls down where a lot of Australian films fall down, and that is the fact that you can't quite just brush off the fact it feels like a television movie. And that's the problem with Australian films. A lot of directors don't have the courage to go over that boundary. Wolf Creek did it. Snowtown did it. But a lot of other films tend to basically stay in the realms of safety. And that's exactly what this film did, which was a great shame because it had the potential of being an absolute classic because the acting was brilliant, especially from Bull, played by Ben Oxenbould. He's one of the most underrated actors in world cinema, in my opinion. He plays a psychotic individual with absolute precision. I thought he was fantastic, and he is the reason why I would suggest you to go out there and watch this film. But when I say that the director played it in safety, he had the grounds to make a really provocative and very, very shocking sort of film, but nothing really bad sort of happens. It threatens the whole film, but it never really delivers what it promises. It has so much potential to be an absolute classic, in my opinion, but it never goes over the boundary of decency, whereas I thought if it had a little bit more balls, it would have been an even better film. But I just couldn't help but feel that it's a very unrewarding sort of experience because of the fact it's great scene, a great setting, fantastic acting, showcases the talent of Australian cinema, but it kind of felt that you've got all the ammunition, but you just don't fire the gun. So I couldn't help but feel that this was a great missed opportunity, and the director has a lot of talent. He created a hell of a lot of suspense, but it just didn't have any rewarding sort of outcome. And as a result, I felt a little bit cheated, and that was a great disappointment because, you know, Australian films have been fairly weak lately, but this one had the grounds to be a great movie, but it just didn't take the opportunity that presented itself. So the soundtrack was great. As I said, acting was great, cinematography fantastic. As I said, there's a very claustrophobic sort of feel. It kind of feels like the boat they're on is in the middle of the universe. That's the center of the universe for them because they can't just, you know, jump off the ship and get away. So that is the reason why it had so much potential, but none of that potential was fully realized. That was the greatest disappointment of the movie. I'm actually going to give it 2.5 stars. I will say go out there and see it based on Ben Oxenbould's performance, but if you're like me, you're expecting something with a little bit of grit, this one will disappoint you. It had such a promise, but unfortunately it just doesn't deliver on any of that. So it was a disappointment, but having said that, it is one of the better Australian films. Although it does feel like a made-for-television movie, it does have a feel that it's one of the better sort of movies of that kind. So Caught Inside, the 2010 Australian film, 2.5 stars, not a terrible film by any means, but definitely a movie that should have been a hell of a lot better than it actually was. Alright guys, that's my review. Hope you enjoyed it. Till next time, keep watching movies, and I'll see you later.